Nothing undermines our cause more greatly than failure to execute our threats.
Destro is an iconic character from the G.I. Joe universe and one of the most cunning villains the Joes have ever faced. In the G.I. Joe A Real American Hero storyline, Destro is the masked man behind Mars Industries, the military armament research syndicate that is a manufacturer of state-of-the-art weapons, which Destro most often sells to the ruthless terrorist organization known as Cobra. Destro's real name is James McCullen Destro the 24th, and he is Lord of Castle Destro, which is located in the Scottish Highlands, where the Destro clan has designed and sold weapons for centuries. The character is immediately identified by the steel mask that he wears, which is a clan tradition dating back to when an ancestor of his was captured by Cromwell's men in the act of selling weapons to both sides, and was forced to wear a steel mask for his crimes. The Destro clan has since turned the wearing of the mask into a symbol of pride, with the tradition being passed down from father to son for over 20 generations. In this first episode of our new video series, G.I. Joe Dossiers, we're going to take a look at the history of Destro in action figures, comics, cartoons, and other media. So stay tuned.
Come with me, toy fans.
Hey, toy fans. My name is Tony, and welcome back to the Analog Toys YouTube channel, where we're obsessed with bringing you the true history of vintage toys and action figures. Destro was first released as an action figure in 1983 as part of the second wave of Hasbro's G.I. Joe A Real American Hero toy line. The figure is dressed in Destro's traditional black outfit that features a deep cut opening down the center of his chest with a red painted collar to give the costume a pop of color. The Destro action figure is armed with a unique laser pistol and equipped with an opening backpack with molded details representing a variety of extra weapons and munitions. Other coloured accents on his outfit include a gold necklace with red medallion, a red drop leg pistol holster, a pair of red wrist rockets mounted onto silver cuffs, and of course his infamous steel mask, which is represented here by a gorgeous fac metalised head.
He's a terrifying enemy of G.I. Joe. Destro is his name.
Destro is his name. Destro.
Introducing Destro.
You better watch out, Joe. Hey, what's going on?
Destro's stealing our tank.
We gotta stop him.
We didn't get you, Destro.
You've met your match, Joe. Destro is here.
G.I. Joe Battle Tank comes with figure, other figures, and Destro sold separately from Hasbro.
The action figure's file card states that Destro provides high-tech arms to any side able to meet his price, and he will incite war where it does not exist. He dons his silver battle mask and enters battle himself, either with Cobra Command or against them if it's better for business. And it's this treacherous duality that makes Destro such an interesting character, and we as children got to learn a lot more about this villain in the pages of Marvel's G.I. Joe comic. Destro first appears on the pages of G.I. Joe A Real American Hero issue number 11, although his face is not seen until issue 14 in a story titled Destro Attacks. Throughout the comic book's run, Destro's strongest connection remains with the Baroness, and these two characters share a complex romantic history. In 1983, the G.I. Joe cartoon first aired on US television, with the character of Destro being voiced by Arthur Burkhart.
This final burst will annihilate them forever!
His accent certainly doesn't sound Scottish. In the Sumbo-produced animated series, Destro is portrayed quite differently to the character in the comic, as he and Cobra Commander have a more scornful relationship.
Success? You dare speak to me of success, you psychotic, sibilant servant of a dolt!
The next Destro action figure to be released would also come out in 1983, in the form of a rare and unusual British variant. Released as part of the popular Action Force toy line, which was designed and manufactured by the Palitoy Company, in this alternate story continuity, the character was renamed Red Jackal, and when standing side by side, you immediately notice the difference between the two figures. Red Jackal has a white painted collar on his tunic, as opposed to Destro's red collar, and the figure's exposed chest area has been painted red and emblazoned with a white skull and crossbone symbol, which represents Baron Ironblood's Red Shadow Army. Unlike the American release of this figure, which was sold on a single figure card back, Red Jackal was sold in the United Kingdom packed in with a boxed vehicle named the Hyena, and this piece of armour also happens to be a British recolour of the Cobra Hiss Tank. I first became aware of the Destro character in 1987 when I began reading the Action Force Weekly comics published by Marvel UK. And contrary to the G.I. Joe storyline, where Destro didn't appear until several issues into the run, In Britain, Destro first graced the pages of Action Force in issue number 1, but he wouldn't get his own full cover until issue number 13. In this comic, Destro would also be treated to his own story, written and drawn by Marvel UK, and titled The Man in the Silver Mask. In 1988, Destro's outfit got a makeover, and we got an exciting new action figure. By this point in the American comic storyline, Destro had moved on from being Cobra's main weapon supplier, and had created a small army of his own. An army whose ranks were filled with soldiers that he calls Iron Grenadiers. The new action figure released by Hasbro would see Destro armed with a gold sword, while his outfit now sported a red cape and gold mask. This figure was also sold in a box with his own vehicle, named Destro's Despoiler.
Tired of the fanatical ravings of Cobra Commander and Serpentor, Destro goes it alone.
Destro's back on the attack, out to conquer the world on his own!
Leading Destro's army is the anti-gravity pod, the AGP.
Who needs Cobra? With my demon and the Iron Grenadiers, neither Joe nor Cobra are a match for me.
Yo, Joe!
Nobody beats the actor, the real American hero!
Can Destro's army destroy Joe and Cobra? Find out at Marvel Comics.
The next few Destro action figures released by Hasbro are actually quite lame and really not worth picking up unless you're a Destro completist. First off, we have the 1992 release of the 3¾-inch figure, with a head that is now painted as opposed to the earlier vac metalized version. Then we have the terrible 12-inch Destro from Hasbro's short-lived G.I. Joe Hall of Fame series. And then in 1993, we were offered what is possibly the worst Destro action figure ever made. The Cobra Tech Commander Destro from the G.I. Joe Star Brigade line. Beyond those action figures, Hasbro has offered a number of anniversary edition Destros, but I'm not going to cover them all here for fear of boring you. There is, however, one significant figure entry in Destro's history that is worth discussing. And that figure is the purple and leopard print variation, infamously known as Pimp Daddy Destro. This extremely rare version of the Destro action figure was released in 2007 as part of an exclusive Cobra Command Team 3 pack. And if you want to learn more about this figure, then I highly recommend reading the Demystified article on the Yojo.com website. A link to that article is in the description below. In 2009, the G.I. Joe franchise had its first crack at a live-action movie with the ill-fated G.I. Joe Rise of Cobra, in which Destro was a key character portrayed by Doctor Who actor Christopher Eccleston.
I've finally taken my place in the long line of my clients.
In 2014, the highly respected 1/6 scale figure manufacturer Sideshow produced an excellent 12-inch interpretation of Destro, and then followed that up in 2017 with a terrific statue of the character. But G.I. Joe fans would have to wait until 2020 before being offered another affordable retail release version of Destro. And that action figure came in Hasbro's new 6-inch scale G.I. Joe classified line. And while I have openly expressed my dislike of this line's first wave, I must admit that Destro is the true standout here, and it is testament to the popularity of the character that he is the only villain included in wave 1 of this line. The figure is dressed in his traditional red and black outfit with silver accents, and he is armed with a gold revolver and a laser gun, and equipped with his signature medallion necklace and a briefcase that can be opened. During the same year, Hasbro also offered consumers Profit Director Destro. And this figure is an interesting recolour of the original 6-inch edition, and one that pays homage to the Pimp Daddy Destro figure from 2007. Profit Director Destro's outfit differs from his classic version by being purple in colour with touches of leopard print, and his steel mask has been changed from silver to gold. His briefcase has also been redone in gold, and he is now accessorised with purple lens sunglasses, a gorgeous leopard print cape, and a stack of burning bills.
I'm only burning my half. All you care about is money.
Hot on the heels of these Hasbro releases, collectors were also offered a 6-inch collectible version of the figure from Mezco. But who knows where the story goes from here. The trailer for Snake Eyes Origins didn't exactly set the world alight, and Destro isn't featured in the movie anyway, so we'll have to wait to see how the public responds to this latest live-action interpretation of G.I. Joe, before casting judgment on Destro's future. Conniving and treacherous, it is characters like Destro that made the G.I. Joe A Real American Hero universe so damned interesting, and I, for one, hope we haven't seen the last of him.
I hope to see you again, my hero.
Destro, how much longer are we going to be Cobra Commander's dupes?
One more arms deal, and I will have everything I will ever need.
So that was the first episode of G.I. Joe Dossiers. Let us know in the comments below which character you'd like to see featured in the next episode. And now you know, and knowing is half the battle. The other half is beating toy scalpers with a bat.